an honor to be here tonight and to have the opportunity to interview Mr. Yang about this remarkable book. We're going to talk for a little bit between the two and a half of us, the three of us. And then we're going to open it up to your questions. So as we're talking up here, have in mind questions you might want to ask Mr. Yang. So I want to begin with the title of the book. The title of the book is Tombstone. So please explain why you gave that title to the book.
There are four reasons for naming this book Tombstone. The first reason is that I'd like to erect a tombstone for those who died. The second reason is to erect a tombstone for my father who died in starvation. The third reason to erect a tombstone is that I want to erect a tombstone before the downfall of the system that caused the Great Famine. The fourth reason, actually, this tombstone is also for myself, because I knew it was a dangerous job to write a book like this, so I erected a tombstone for myself, in case, just in case. Just to quote an ancient Chinese saying, who would be afraid of dying? I'm not.
Happens to all of us. So it's best to live a full life rather than a frightened one. So. And we are grateful for your courage. So tell the story, it's a very sad story, of how you discovered the famine and how it affected your family. I was in the second year of my senior high school. It was the spring of 1959. My high school, which was the only school in the county, was 10 kilometers away from my village. A childhood friend came to my school and told me that my father was dying.
And
asked me to take some rice back home to visit my father. So I went to the student cafeteria asking them to stop my rationing of food for 3 days so I could take 1.5 kilos of rice back to my dad. So for students at those schools, public schools, we were guaranteed some food. So after I gave my father the rice, and my father urged me to leave. So I went out to the fields and dug out some of wild vegetables and gave him those wild vegetables, then I left.
So
after
我告诉他,他还懒得回来怎么办呢?等我死了以后,再告诉他。
I did not realize my my father was in such a serious condition. He could not eat the rice at all, and he knew he was dying. So he urged me to leave. And then he told his neighbors that don't tell me the news of my death of his death until he passes away.
过了几天，后来小朋友告诉我，你父亲死了。
I didn't return home again until a few days later when my childhood friend came with the bad news. I went back and my father was already dead.
But you did not realize at the time that this was a wider problem.
就是那时候你并不知道这个是一个大的问题，是普遍的问题。我认为是一个家庭个人不幸。
二如果是我的责任，因为如果我在家里不上学、挖野菜，我父亲不至于我死了。
I blame myself. I thought my father's death was an individual case, I thought it was because I was in my school in the county away from home, so I was not around to dig out wild veggies to feed him.
When did you realize that this was a big problem and not just a problem in your village?
就是说，你什么时候觉得这是一个更普遍的问题，不光是你们村子，这就很长的时间。
Took me
a long time.
一直到文化革命中间。Not
until in the middle of the Cultural Revolution.
当然，省长张体学，湖北省省长，说，说大饥荒饿死30万人湖北省，说的。他是给你说的？不是给他跟王任重两个意见不一致，他批判王任重说，批判省委书记王任重。
So, until in the middle of the Cultural Revolution, the governor of my province, the Hubei province, was criticizing the party secretary of the of the Hubei province, blaming him, and that was the time when it disclosed. Disclosed the figure that 300,000 people had died of starvation in that province alone.
And was that number accurate?
这30万这个准确吗？实际少了，可能湖北省死过50-60万人吧。 Much less, actually.
And what was the real number?
那是真的那个数字是多少？
估计是五六十万，六十万。我书上有这个湖北省的数字。
As I wrote in my book, I estimated the figure at somewhere between 500,000 and 600,000.
But that was only in your province. So, in the nation,
只是湖北嘛。湖北省。
In the nation, what is our best estimate of how many people died in the famine?
就是说全国的话，你大概估计是。全国三千，我书上是3600万。 My estimate for the whole China, the those who died in starvation would be 36 million.
36 million, unbelievable. It's incredible, incredible tragedy.
不可思议。
So many people think of famine as being caused by a bad harvest.
好多人都怪了这个饥荒啊，实际上是就是。
But this case, you blame political forces. Explain what caused the famine and the starvation and the tragedy.
但是你在书中啊，你是实际上你是批判这个政治制度，你觉得是政，你能不能多讲一下这政治制度是个原因？当时你为了是官方说是因为天灾造成饥荒。 The official explanation was that it was caused by natural disasters.
为了解决这个问题，我多次去国家气象局查当年天灾的气象历史。To
solve this mystery, I went to the National Bureau of Meteorology and did a lot of research.
我的结论是天灾。